I'm gonna give y'all the stop, drop, and roll of bullying. You know why stop, drop, and roll works, educators? Because it's simple, it's action-based, and it's life-saving. I'll say it one more time. It's simple, it's action-based, it's life-saving. I'm gonna give them the stop, drop, and roll of bullying. You know where I got it from, students? Well, duh, I've been to superhero school. And in superhero school, they teach you a couple things. And they give you something. They give you the starter pack of superpowers. Now see, when I was in school, students, there was this kid, his name was Brian. And he was different. Like, he didn't change in gym class, he would put his head up against the lockers. He was different than everybody else. He was an easy target. And see, I never did a single thing to help him. I didn't know it was my job. And even if I did, I didn't know what to do. But after I came back from superhero school, when they said, just use one of the starter packs, see, when I got there, I was like, man, I can't do this. And they're like, don't worry about it. These ones, they're as easy as the ABCs. They said, the next time you walk in the locker room and people aren't treating Brian the right way, they said, you don't have to talk to that person that's being mean, disrespectful, that maybe even bullying Brian. They said, all you got to do is fly over there and use your first superpower. All you got to do is fly over there and do this. Yo, Brian, my locker's stuck. Could you help me? And they said, just take Brian. They said, just take Brian away. Ha! You know how they knew that, educators? Because they watch superhero movies. And what's the first thing a superhero does? Fly in and take the person away. Here's the next one. Check this one out. This is the hardest superpower of them all, students. Don't underestimate it, though. Become Brian's buddy. Now, some of you are going to say, well, that ain't a real superpower. I'll bet you it is. Y'all think Superman would see somebody falling from a building, and as that person's falling from the building, y'all think Superman would do this? Like, as this dude's falling from a building. Imagine Superman doing this. Well, I'm going to let this one hit the street. You think Superman would do that?
No!
That's why he's Superman. Superman don't care who his dad is. Superman don't care what he smells like, what he looks like. Superman treats everybody like it's his buddy. There's only one reason you won't use this superpower. The next time you see someone not being treated the right way, someone with their feelings hurt. One reason. You ready? Because you ain't a superhero yet. Now, you could. Every single one of you in here got buddies. You know how to treat them. The next time you see someone that got their feelings hurt, become their buddy. Ask them to go outside today. Throw that football. Y'all know Brian can't throw no football, let alone catch it. Who cares? Neither can one of your other buddies, but you'll ask them. Here's the last one. C, confront the situation. Now, I've seen all the superhero movies. Sometimes they confront it differently. Sometimes they get between people and say, stop. But most of the time, they use their superpower. Now, listen real carefully here, students. Sometimes your superpower doesn't work. I've seen all the movies, and sometimes their superpower doesn't work. So sometimes you gotta call another superhero. See, I've seen the movie where even Superman needed Batman's help at the end. Sometimes you gotta call another superhero, students. You see, these educators, you ask them to help you, they'll help you. It might even be a friend of yours. It might be a cousin. It might be an aunt and uncle. A, take them away. B, become their buddy. I dare you. Hardest superpower of them all. C, you got to confront the situation with your superpower. That doesn't work, you got to call another superhero for help.
All right, students, we're deep into button number 5, this thing called heroes, people that are willing to do things other people aren't willing to do, like look silly or ridiculous. We got our famous goggles on that have been with us for years. And we know that's one reason, coach, that kids don't jump into action is they feel silly or ridiculous. So we kind of model that and we have them practice becoming vulnerable and they don't know what to do. So we're going to talk about that here in just a second, coach, when we talk about different superpowers that kids have.
One of the things that we do to break the ice on this whole silliness thing and some of the vulnerability that you have to be a superhero for someone is we talk about the stop, drop, and roll of bullying. And when, you know, you think of stop, drop, and roll, to actually get down on the ground is a little simple and kind of silly feeling and maybe looking if I were to practice and demonstrate it, right, if we weren't in the real situation. But you know what it does? It saves, and then my students always say, lives. And this is a life-saving technique, or it can be a life-saving technique. And it's all about practicing these strategies, practicing these skills of being okay with the awkwardness, the silliness, and jumping into action, becoming that superhero.
That's right. And then we leave kids with a real strategy, and we say it's as simple as the ABCs to stop, drop, and roll of bullying. And we give kids the starter pack of superpowers that you and I got from superhero school. So that's really part of the discussion question today, Coach, in this circle, is to get in there and to start to recognize what your individual superpower is. And the best way I like to do it is I like to hear from other people. So don't really talk too much about your superpower in the circle. I want you to look across that circle and talk about the different superpowers that some of the other kids have in the room. And a lot of times kids think, well, I didn't realize that was my superpower, you know, my humor. Yeah, you could use that to save someone. And then of course we know that if your superpower doesn't work, sometimes you gotta call another superhero for help. We're gonna come back with one more video that focuses on the most important thing when it comes to jumping into action and becoming someone's hero.